Good morning, sir. My name is Srinu. So here I am working under Phatak, sir. So I am presenting my report as a final PPT. So my topic is massive open online courses, enhancement to edX platform. Okay. So here you can see the outline. The first section is about massive open online courses. So in this section, I'm gonna introduce what is MOOC and what are the advantages and what are the challenges and few existing MOOCs. So just go to the introduction to MOOC. Yeah, here you can see the picture. A MOOC, which is taken from Wikipedia, and it is explaining each and every letter in MOOC. First, what is the M in MOOC word? M is massive. So before 2011, massive users, it's about 1000 people, maybe below that, but now it's crossed lakh of people, lakhs of people in some MOOCs. So M, we are considering him massive, is a unlimited participants in online courses, and which is taken from I given a citation here. You can see it. Massive is unlimited participants, and open, second letter is open. Open, it is free and not limited by the geography. Accessible, no prerequisites is required as traditional methods, and content will be shared. Next, the third letter, online. It is mostly based on internet based. Some of the MOOCs are offering offline learning also, but mostly on internet based. It also maybe work with mobile technology. The last letter in MOOC word is courses. Learning will be involved by the interaction between the instructors and students, and with the help of forums and chart boxes and extra. So we'll go to the next slide. Yeah, what are the advantages of the MOOC? The main aim of the MOOC is large scale interactive participation of users with the help of web. We can see some other learning management systems also available on the web. Those are Moodle and Dotland, eFront, and etc. But these are a lack of large scale interactive participations. Maybe they can up to support around 2,000 to 2,500 users at a current stage. But here, when we come to the MOOC, we can support up to lakhs of people, maybe 1 million or more than that. So the main aim of the MOOC is interactive participation. Okay, next, what are the various features offered by the MOOC? First one is videos and study materials will be available, and quizzes will be conducted, online exams, and also the MOOC developers trying to make it more efficient than the traditional education systems, which is brick and mortar way, face-to-face learning, and free access to organized content. Students can make global connections. There are the areas which are not aware of quality of education because of the resources available in that areas, and if these kind of areas can access quality education from the established universities with the help of MOOC systems, but the internet should be accessed in those areas. And okay, these MOOC systems also helping careers of the students. For example, Udacity offering online courses for free, and anyone can opt the courses, and after that proctored exams also offered. Proctored exams means student will write the exams under the supervision of somebody, So after that, they will offer certificates, and also they will provide some provision of jobs, provision of career opportunities. So after that, learner can use any online tool that are relevant to these MOOC systems. We'll go to the next slide. As I mentioned, people have no access to formal higher educations, where the corners of some countries can participate actively in MOOC systems. This is informal and can be organized easily. Which is informal means a student can watch the videos, student can attend the quizzes based on the requirements of that MOOC. This is informal. One can learn anytime, anywhere, and learning will be possible by the collaboration of learners and instructors, and it supports career opportunities. Okay, still MOOC is coming with day by day with the help of advanced technologies. Still the high dropout rate because of the lack of motivation of the students. So how to increase the throughput of the e-learning industry, how to utilize it in a good manner? So some of the challenges are we listed here. The first one is the accreditation, which is saying that how you will grade when you conducted a final exam for a large scale of people. Let us say 1 million people finished one final exam, then how can you grade them, whether peer-to-peer evaluation or instructor evaluation or automated grading, which one you will choose. So the ultimately the final, the best solution will be automated grading. So that will be the one challenge. And next one is the self regulation and motivation of the participants, which means students. The successful completion rate in e-learning industry is about 5% and below the 5% because of the lack of motivation and the regulation. So how to increase the motivation of a student and how to regulate them? This will be the one of the problem, and high dropout rate, and assuring academic integrity, learning analytics. So based on the learning analytics, we can come to know that how a student is behaving on the learning objects. Learning objects means here anything which is giving information to learn something. Maybe one PDF file will be the learning object, and one video lecture will be the learning object. So how a student is attempting the learning objects. First, what he is doing. Whether he is going to directly assignments, or he is listening to the videos, or he is reading the documents, provided documents. So these will be the learning analytics. So by doing the learning analytics, so how most of the students are behaving, if you know that, then we can give a proper way to motivate them. So next, as I said, automated grading, this will be the one of the challenge, and standards on grading. So maybe MOOC is available to all over the world. So standards are different from university to university. Because of that, we are getting world rankings, these kind of all these things. So when one world top class university offering MOOC courses, then how the other university students will receive it? This will be the one of the problem. So whether that students need to come up to these level, best universities level, or then these lectures should go to their level to explain in better. And existing MOOC systems, the one is edX-MOOC and Coursera, Udacity, edX and edX. I'm not going through the detailed in these MOOC systems because we have a less time, and so I'm skipping these things. I will explain these things clearly in my main presentation. Okay, next one is the related work and literature survey. So in literature work and literature survey, you can see here the outline. First, we concentrated on feature-based survey of different learning management systems. The first one is open source LMS management systems, and the second one is proprietary-based learning management systems. The second one is targeting the profit, and these are the profit-based systems. So we'll go to the feature-based survey. We surveyed around 13 LMSs of open source. The first one is here you can see Moodle, eFront, Sakai, Canvas by Instructor, Fedena, OLAT, and Claroline, Dotland, Dogeys, A-Tutor, Chemilo, Ilias, Tutor LMS, and etc. So what we did, we given introduction to these systems, so where they came up and who developed it, and after that we listed some of most important features to each and every LMS. So I'm not presenting here, it will take too much time. So the next and finally we considered some of the features from this entire 13 LMSs, and we concluded that features those are going to implement in our model. So that is in our model, which is I'm gonna present in later. These are the proprietary based LMSs: Blackboard Learning System and Edmodo, Informatica, MyBig Campus, Sclipo, and etc. These are all based on profit based companies. So next, the concluded features. Here I concluded some around 8 features from those total. 13 are open source LMSs and 12 are proprietary based LMSs. So from the 25 LMSs, we made some comparison roughly. I'm not presenting here. So we concluded 8 features. So first, learn these eight features are going to implement in our model. So the first one, learning paths will given by the instructor. So what these learning paths saying that how student will proceed when he learns a course, when he learns some topic. So first you do these things, you read some materials, after that you see these videos, after that you go to the assignments and you do it, and after that attempt these quizzes, these way of path. So this way of path will be given by the instructor, and the student should be followed that to get the better results. And the next one is better navigations. We are trying to give a better navigations in existing MOOC system. So that MOOC system is edX. We are going to use the edX in our campus, that is IIT Bombay. So in that so we are trying to implement a better navigation system. And the next one is self-paced learning. So based on the student requirement, learning will be proceeded. So these things, so when he want to learn something, then that those kind of information will be provided to him. So after that, when he finishes it, then he can learn anything. So no deadlines will be there. So this is the self-paced learning. Next one is the offline learning. So currently offline learning is not available in the edX, so this one also we are trying to make it. And the next one is power presentation authoring, SMS alerts, mobile access, competency management, and adaption of learning styles into LMS. First of all, what are the learning styles? Learning style is one's learning preference, so how he would like to learn something, in which way. So actually everyone has their own learning style. So what are the main point is here, our teachers can assess the learning style of students in a class, and then they can adapt the classroom methods to suit each and every student. So this is the main aim of the thing, so to get the better results. So general learning styles, one is visual, and then next one is auditory, and the last one is the kinesthetic and or tactical. So what the visual is doing? So in visual category, students will try to understand the things by the diagrammatical and pictorial representations, and or by watching some videos. And the next, auditory, In auditory category, students are trying to attend the lectures mostly. So they are listening by vocabulary or listening class, listening to somebody. The last one, kinesthetic and tactile. These people are learning by doing something active with the course. They are good at solving problems. Why are we considering these learning styles? So, because why we are considering these learning styles? The dropout rate is very high in e-learning industry, as I mentioned in earlier slides. So we would like to improve the successful completion rate using these learning styles. So how we proceed will be given in later slides. So to increase the successful completion rate, we proposed our model. So before that, I'm going to discuss a few models. So this is the first model I'm going to take is David Cobb's model. So from this David Cobb's model, there are four categories of students. The first one is converger, diverger, assimilator and accommodator. The first one, they are good at practical applications and solving problems. The second one is diverger, they are good at imagination and come up with the new ideas. And assimilator, they are good at inductive reasoning and creating theoretical models. Accommodator, they learn by doing things and engaging with others actually. So you can see here a picture how they are classified based on concrete experience and reflect to and act to experimentation and abstract conceptualization. By these four categories, based on two of them, there will be one category. So this is what says David Cope's model. The next one we consider is the Felder-Silverman learning model. So here he has also come up with four categories. The first one is sensing learners and intuitive learners. So the sensing learners, what they like facts, and whether here they like discover possibilities and relationships. These are the differences I given here. And you can see here also the next one is active learners and reflective learners. Active learners, they learn by doing something active with it. The reflective learners prefers to think about it first. After that, they will do it. These two kinds of learners belongs to only one category. They will fluctuate between these two things. And the third one is sequential learners and global learners. Sequential learners, when they learn, they like to follow a sequential steps, and they will understand each and everything in every step, and they'll conclude the whole concept at the end. But in the global learners, they will get a big picture first. They will get some idea, whole idea first, and then they will understand each and every functionality in that picture. So these are these things. And the last one is visual learners and verbal learners. Visual learners, as you can see here, they learn things best by watching pictures and diagrams, flow films and demonstrations. Verbal learners learns more from written and spoken explanations. In the next one, Neil Fleming's back and work model. So here are the same: visual learners, auditory learners, reading writing preference learners, and kinesthetic learners and tactile learners. As I given here, as you can see here, I given already definitions of these learners. And okay, we are concluding of the learning styles. So I consider these learning styles, and also I've seen these learning style candidates in my educational career. So some of my friends are like to learn while looking at the pictorial representations and visual things, like when somebody explaining on the board, instructor. So they like to learn at the time. But some of my friends, they don't like to attend the classes. They will learn things by reading textbooks. Okay, they won't attend the classes, but the end of the semester, they will read 2-3 textbooks and they will attend exams, and they will finish the exam with good grades. These kind of learners also I've seen. The third one is experimental learners. First, the third category is will go to directly to the problems, assignments, because here the problem is experimental learners, they will need some prerequisite knowledge about the course. So they will have some knowledge. Suppose somebody did the course, but he's not sure about that course completely. So what he do? He will go somewhere online MOOC and he will attempt the assignments and quizzes to learn best. So he has already prerequisite knowledge. Then he will do assignments directly. No need of listening all of the videos and no need of reading all of the materials. We consider these three learning styles. So we proposed our model here. So first of all, how we find the learning styles? So in order to find the learning style, a questionnaire will be provided to the student at the time of the course registration in a MOOC system. So that course will include maybe 10 to 15 that questionnaire may include nearly 10 to 15 questions. Based on the responses, we will decide in which category that student will be there. So based on these three categories, so after the finding of learning style of a student, we will come up with these proposal. See, here you can see CS101, the course, first the main course. So after this course, we will create four different courses based on that CS101. The first course, as you can see here, CS101 visual. So this course mainly contains videos and pictorial representation, and mostly this is this is to target visual learners. The second one is read and write, CS101 read and write course. This course is mostly targeting the read and write type learners. So in this course there will be no videos, but there will be mostly read and write materials. And the third one is CS101 experimental. So in this there will be all assignments and solved problems, these kind of things will be there. So based on that, the last one is CS101 common. So this will contains entire the rest of three courses. So this is CS101 common. So when one student is registering the course, he can skip the learning style thing and he can go to the direct CS101 common course. And if you want to try it, and he can go and attempt the questionnaire, and after that we will classify him based on his responses. Then we will have one of these course, whether a visual or read and write or experimental. So apart from this, we would like to maintain a repository which will contain each and everything related to a course. So suppose when a student attempting visual course, so he is some uneasy with a visual kind of course, so he can go to the main repository of that course, and in that course everything will be available, reading materials, everything. So he can go and he can check anything. So at that time we would like to track how that student is going to attempting the learning objects. Based on that, if he attempting more on reading materials when he is attempting to visual course, then we would like to suggest him, so you would like to change your learning style or not. So that is up to based on his choice. So first we would like to find learning style. After that we will suggest one of this course, and after that if he wants to attempt the main repository, and we will track the activities of the student, and we will suggest him after that. So the main aim here is we would like to motivate him in order to complete the course. The next one is edX-MOOC. EDX is the youngest MOOC, we can say like that, youngest MOOC in e-learning industry. So we will see the first. EDX is a non-profit organization which is founded by major universities in the world, which are Harvard and MIT. So this has open sourced in June 1 of 2013, and all over the world people are trying to make more effective than the traditional education. So So these are developed based on the Django framework. The user technologies are Python, Ruby, Perl, and Node.js. Excuse me. So the database is MongoDB and SQLite. So along these edX-MOOC developed as different modules at a time, and after that they are integrated together to make a complete system. So here you can see that these are the main modules of edX-MOOC. So these modules need to be integrated to come up with a complete system in order to offer courses and in order to host somewhere. So you can see here edX-ORA, edX platform code gel, XQ and X server, CS comment service. So I will explain it in my main PPT clearly, as you know already them. So here you can see the interface of the LMS of edX. So one can register now here with a register now button, and after login and he will go to the search courses and he can opt the courses and some of the features: self-paced learning, online test and assignments, subtitles of videos, search will be there, activation emails, and the number of students enrolled in your course, you can see that thing, and online discussion groups, and these are the all features. And this is the CMS, and this part is mainly for instructor. One can register here and sign in here. After that he can create a course, and after that he can invite students all over the world. So these are the main features: adding videos, creating assignments, and import export course, add course team, live view and preview. This live view preview is how students is viewing that course. When you create a course, this will show that thing. And adding grading policy, course updates, updating static pages also, and outline. Here outline you can see based on edX-MOOC, we are trying to implement one blended learning model. We are considering it as a new methodology in education system in the world. When we go to the introduction to blended learning, so here the blended learning is a combination of two aspects: face-to-face learning, which is a brick and mortar method, and the next one is online learning. So the combination of these things will make blended learning. In our model, what we are going to do: first, CS101 computer programming and utilization course will be offered by Professor Deepak B. Phatak from IIT Bombay, and after that we will approach different colleges in India with our proposal. Here different colleges will include well-established universities and affiliated colleges under that universities. So these universities has to collaborate with us to implement our model. So what is our proposal? All students related to the all engineering colleges need to opt this course CS101. It is mandatory under predefined terms of conditions. So what students do actually, in every engineering college there will be one CS101 programming course in the first year of BTEC. So we would like to replace that course with our CS101 computer programming and utilization course. So after agreement of the colleges, we will train the local instructors with face-to-face interaction with a super instructor. Here the super instructor will be from IIT Bombay. So training includes how the training process will goes. So we will select places based on a poll or convenience of the local instructors. Then we will conduct the training process, and after that training process will include introduction to Unix OS, programming tutorials, and a grading system. EDC will be trained to them. So after that, entire information related to CS101 course will be given by IIT Bombay only. Assignments, quizzes, final exams will be by IIT Bombay only. So after this, when we go to the grading of assignments, what it will do, grading, how we can do the grading of for a mass amount of people, students. So we would like to implement one method, peer-to-peer evaluation, which was offered by Professor Deepak B. Phatak in CS101 course for 3 years in IIT Bombay. So how it will do, first in a group of student, in a branch of students, students will be divided into groups. So let us take 3 groups. So one group will be graded the other group, and the other group will be graded the some other group. So finally these 3 groups need to communicate with the local instructor in order to give the final grades. So this will we got a fruitful results when we applied here. So and the entire 100% marks of a course will be divided like this: 80% of marks from IIT Bombay and 20% of marks from the local instructor. So final grades will be sent to respective colleges after the final exam. So grading can be either automated or peer-to-peer grading. So this is the hierarchy you can see here, and the advantages of our model. So elimination of duplicate work for local instructors in a mass of around 10,000 instructors. No need to prepare documents and videos for day by day classes. And you can see some other better training and better teaching, better learning. Successful completion rate can be increased up to 99%. Because of this is mandatory to every student. So if everybody participated, then without dropouts, then we can increase it up to 99%. But presently successful completion rate is about 5%. So you can see the main difference here. So the main aim of this model is to increase the successful completion rate with a quality of education. So minimum pass grade will be given, because people will afraid standards of IIT Bombay. So that's why we are including this minimum pass grade. And the next challenges. So the main challenge is, does edX-MOOC supports our model or not? And what are the architectural, technical, administrational issues? What database tables need to be created? What to be modified? After that, implementation of our model, testing and deployment. So how we can assure the academic integrity and automated grading? These are our challenges, and we would like to cross these barriers in our next stage. And the last one is my problem statement. So the main aim is to provide motivation. What is the motivation behind the problem statement? The main aim is to provide quality education all over the world with a successful completion rate, increased successful completion rate. So the dropout rate need to be decreased, and throughput of the e-learning industry is very low currently. So we'd like to increase it to improve successful completion rate of a course. And so we come up with our model, blended learning MOOC model of IIT Bombay learning, with the help of edX-MOOC. First we would like to implement in Indian colleges. After that we will approach respective people for the worldwide use. So my problem statement will be here: implementation of blended learning MOOC model of IIT Bombay. We are trying to implement this fast, and after that integration of all modules, what I presented in earlier slides. These slides are CS Common Services, CodeGL, XP, X Server, edX-ORA. These are to improve the functionality of edX-MOOC system. So still, if time permits us, after the completion of our 2 tasks, we will consider the following issues: adaption of learning styles into edX-MOOC and into our model also, and the implementation of following features in the next slide. Implementation of the features which are presented in related survey. Those are here, concluded features. These 8 features we are going to implement if time permits us, along with the learning styles. Thank you, sir.